My students learn the physics better when they are acting as though they are true physicists. I try to teach as much as possible in a project-based approach in all of my classes. I've seen enough success out of what it does for students that I'm hooked on it. One of the things about the project that I think helps to make it successful and the style of teaching successful is that students are motivated because it's a real task and they assume the role of a job that actually exists. The project that I'm working on with my AP Physics class is called The Mission to Mars. The students were creating testable landers that contained 4 eggs, so it was a very well thought out egg drop experiment.
You guys are in the role of the EDL systems engineer, entry, descent, and landing to try to make a lander that will end up on Mars.
When they see that there's this interesting problem that is being tackled out there and is a thing that can lead to an actual job for them, they're much more motivated to look deeper at the actual physics behind it.
It's like we're all being acted upon by like great forces all the time. It just happens that the time of it.
The very first task is the project launch. And in that activity, students investigate past designs of EDL systems that have landed rovers.
And then we gotta figure out how we're gonna attach these. So like if we're gonna use tape or glue or maybe zip ties or something.
The early stages of the project is getting motivated and understanding the context. Students really try to map out what are gonna be the set of skills they'll need to learn in order to tackle that problem. As a teacher looking in on those days, it might look like a traditional physics lab. My role then is to make sure that students stay in character as a system engineer. From there, students tackle air resistance, which is one of the concepts in a lot of introductory physics courses.
We use the parachute to work with that. So we were trying to make the lowest terminal velocity possible by increasing the surface area.
You still need to finish up your terminal velocity investigation so that I know you can quantify terminal velocity and you can apply it to your lander.
From there, students develop a deeper understanding of impulse and the change in momentum of their lander as it makes contact with the surface of Mars.
So we have 4 50-gram weights, one for each egg that we'll have in the actual test run. And so that's just the masses that we're using to simulate. We used different airbag designs. And so we used methods like using force plate and dropping it on a force plate to measure how long the force was applied over.
The force spiked when it first hit, and then you can see that it bounced a couple times.
These little air pockets right here, I feel like that's really gonna help cushion the fall.
The task before students actually test their landers is an energy analysis. During that time, students uncover and investigate some of the important concepts of mechanical energy, work, and the conservation of energy. Another big part of project-based learning for me is that students have a public product. So they're not just learning in isolation from a textbook and learning how to do problems that they can then write out on a piece of paper and have me evaluate and grade.
And how did you decide? Did you experiment at all with different sizes of parachutes?
We had a number of experts come in on that day, engineers that worked in industry, to evaluate and give feedback to the students.
Nice. Yeah. 3, 2, 1. All right, we got 4 out of 4.
Yeah.
No hairline crashes?
No.
I'm curious about the airbag system.
Yeah, me too. You have Mr. Divine like telling us that these are the things that people actually do, but that's different than having people who are actually in the job being like, yes, this is the thing that I do. This is some things that I noticed.
Yeah, your guys' is actually the one that I thought was good because it seems like you guys thought in the 3D space maybe more, in that many of these designs look like they rely primarily on the airbag or the parachute, right? It was good to see the kids being able to look at those equations and use them to help guide the design, because that's exactly what we have to do in industry.
You can think of it conceptually, actually being able to test it, and you have to repeat the equations over and over and over again with different trials of different airbags and different parachutes. Just being able to use that math over and over again helps it stick.
They are much more eloquent with their explanations, much more agile with their application of the concepts when I've seen them construct the knowledge themselves versus simply be handed a tool and explained how that tool works.
All right, everybody ready?